Good morning students, today we will draw the sectional view of the hexagonal pyramid. Here one of the simple question is given based on that hexagonal pyramid. Let us see that question first. Hexagonal pyramid with side of base 30 mm and axis 70 mm long is resting with its base on horizontal plane and two edges of the base are parallel to VP. It is cut by a sectional plane parallel to HP and passing through the axis at a point 30 mm from the apex. Draw the projections of the remaining pyramid. That is the question. So we need to understand that question first. The base side is given 30 mm and total axis length is 75 mm. It is resting on the horizontal plane with one of the edges parallel to VP, and at the same time the length 30 mm from the apex point, 30 mm from the apex. So you can see 30 mm from the apex, the sectional plane is passing on that axis line. So that is the condition of this pyramid. So now let us draw the sectional views of that given pyramid. So you can see this pyramid. So in that when the pyramid is resting on the horizontal plane, that is on HP, the true shape is hexagonal shape, and that is drawn in the horizontal plane only in the top view. So if you consider this is this one, so this is the xy axis line, and below to this one top view and above to that one is the front view. So in the top view first we are drawing, beginning with the top view, because that is the true shape. So condition is given, one side is parallel. So this is side is when this side is drawn parallel to that reference line, that is nothing but parallel to vertical plane. And from this point and this point, take the 120 degrees, and here also 120 degrees, just draw the line 30 mm length, here also 30 mm length. Once again take the 120 degrees of line here and 120 degrees line here, and just draw the two lines, and then after just drawing the each length of the side is equal to 30 mm. So finally you got the hexagonal shape. And to get the center of that pyramid, that is apex point, just draw the diagonal lines, all diagonal lines. So the wherever the diagonals are meeting, that is the apex point for that pyramid. So here this edge lines as well as this diagonal lines, all the lines are dark lines only, because these are the triangular faces for the pyramid. So all these are triangular edges, that is why all the lines need to be darkened. So in the front view you will get a shape like this, and you just give the numbering to this hexagonal shape. So I am starting the numbering from this point, so that is A, B, C, D, E and F. And now project all the points onto the reference line from A and from B and C and D, like that. So here A is single line, D also single line, but from B and F two lines are passing on the single line, C and D also passing on the same single line, and just join that lines by horizontal line, that gives the baseline of the pyramid. And through the center point just draw the axis line, and the height of the axis line you have to consider 75 mm. Up to here you have to take 75 mm. Then after, from this projectional point just join to that apex point, so you got the front view diagram, of the pyramid. And now this pyramid is cut by the sectional plane, and that sectional plane is parallel to the horizontal plane. At the same time it is passing through the axis line at a height of 30 mm from the apex. From this apex point it is considered 30 mm, and through this point it is considering parallel to the horizontal. When it is parallel means the line is like this only. So just it is cutting parallelly like this to the horizontal plane, and these are the points on the edge lines of the pyramid. So So these all these are the triangular edge lines for the pyramid, and it is cutting those edge lines or those points. So now give the numbering to those points. So this one is 1, and next 2, and this point is 3, and this point 4, and once again 5 and 6. Those are the cutting points on those edge lines. And now from those points 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So from those points just draw the vertical lines like this. So this is the O to one line, O to A line. So here this point is the O and O to A line. So intersecting O to A line at this point. So this is the O to A edge line. So in the top view, that line is here. Similarly, second and sixth points are on O to B and O to F line. So just extend this point onto those lines. O to B line, O to F line is cut by this second point and sixth point. Similarly, this line is C, O to C line and O to E line. So here O to E line is this one, O to C line is this one. So you need to draw the projection line of that point, intersection point, like this. So it is intersecting on these two points. And last final one is fourth point, and it is on O to D. So here O to D is this one. So when you project this point onto O to D line, it is intersecting over here. Now join 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, and 6 to 1, like that. So you will get that intersection. So when you join this point, this is the sectional top view. So in order to represent sectional views, it has to be hatched. That portion has to be hatched. So this portion has to be hatched by this hatching lines. So like that, if you draw, then it gives the sectional top view. So simply front view and this top view are enough when it is cut by the sectional plane parallel to the horizontal plane, because this this shape is the true shape only. This sectional shape is when you see from the top view as it is parallel to the horizontal plane. This plane is whatever the cutting section is there, that you can see true length only. That is why no need to draw the true shape once again. And when you see from this direction, so only this portion is visible, and there is no possibility to see the top surface from this direction. That is why no need to draw the side view also. So just two views are enough, that is front view and this top view. So this is the sectional top view, and this one is the sectional front view. So in this way you can easily draw the sectional views of any solid. Thank you.